disinformation is related to the face recognition, but of course it has been created in 2011, so the approach is on the geometrical approach, whereby we use a feature extractions to get the face information, then we recognize the face using the image. Okay, when we start with this face recognition, actually we start with the fundamentals of face recognition. Then I realized that we need to apply it on the attendants. So what we did is we transform these face recognition to attendants by recognizing the face of people who attend the class or attend the event or even attend of come to the office. My inspirations for doing this started with the attendance of the classes, because it's compulsory for us to take students' attendance. And it takes sometimes hassle to do it, because we have to take the attendance using pen and pencil and papers. Then we have to key in through the system. And it takes time for us, for our busy life. So if, let's say, we have this kind of innovations with the system, they will automatically generate a list of attendance. The challenges on the innovations, of course, in terms of the imaging and the face, because some people have wearing spectacles, some students or some people using scarf, and mustache involved, and then sometimes they move around. So all these have to be considered. So we approach using the clustered images, and also we have to make sure to minimize any changes of the face, because sometimes the student take off the spectacles, sometimes they choose different wear the hijab. So all these have to be considered in our project. Alright, what we have here is a MATLAB program that interacts with the OpenCV to identify images that we use to capture images and detect the images to recognize people. Yeah, first we have to select image. We can use a normal camera or even the web camera. Then we detect the image. Yeah. So you can see we detect the images, and then we eliminate non-images. Yeah, next, we have the non-face removing. So any non-face we will remove from the image. Yeah. Next, then we have to normalize, because the position, we can see the face with a different position, different orientations. So we have to normalize and then detect with the database, right? Then we have to click the recognition to recognize. Yeah, we can see the 30% match from the database that we have. And then we have the attendance list. So that's the attendance list. This is what we did, but for the information, we produced this, we developed this in 2011. So we might have to upgrade it and update it using the artificial intelligence and current technology.